people, I'm glad to be here today on Living Real with Sarah. My name is Sarah Bukola Adeoye, and on the parenting series, we are going ahead to Parenting 103. We have seen Parenting 101, where we laid the foundation, Parenting 102, where we discussed about accepting our children. Today, we are going on to praying for our children. You have to pray for your children, whether you feel like it or not. It is an obligation that you have towards them. When you don't pray for your children, do you know what you're doing? You are leaving their life to chances. God expects you to commit them daily. Give us this day our daily bread. It is something you have to do daily. Oh Lord, I commit my child into your hands. I commit my daughter into your hands. As he or she is going to school, Lord, preserve her. Give her understanding. Give her wisdom. These are things that you are supposed to do as a parent. It's one of your core responsibilities. The Ten Commandments that is popularly known, we all know it's from God. The fifth one talks about honoring your father and your mother. And it says, when you do that, it will be well with you and you will live long on earth. That means there's a correlation between living long, living, you know, a long life and a good life. There's something correlating between that and being good to your parents. In other words, it's like something that comes as a reward for honoring your parents. It means as a parent, you have that grace to release blessing, to release long life onto your children. And it is just the wise thing to do. This life is not fair. It doesn't give to anybody what he deserves. It will only give to you what you demand and what you take from it. And we all know that children don't even know how to do anything for themselves. Until they come of age, when they become accountable, you are the custodian of that sin, of that lovely soul. And you just have to commit them to God daily. When you pray for your children, you know what you're doing? You are committing their destiny, their future, into the hands of their creator. And you are protecting and shielding them away from evils in this world. I remember something that happened when my children were much younger. You know, I had this habit of praying for them. You know, when I'm washing their heads, I'm praying, I'm decreeing. You will be the head and not the tail. You will be above and not beneath. It shall be well with you and stuff like that. Then one of my cousins came around and he saw me doing that and was like, wow. He said, I've just learned something from this. When I have my children, I'm going to be doing this for them. Then he said something I will not forget. He said, if my parents had been doing this for me since I was a child, I would have gone farther than where I am right now. And that is what it does, really. Prayer makes your children to move at a supernatural level, at a supernatural pace. And you know, we are seeing of women, especially, I don't know what men do this, that curse their children. And they'll say, if I carried you in my womb, and if you saw this breast, then let this thing happen, let that thing happen, because they are angry. I know that children could at times, you know, be very, very wonderful. But then, it is not right for a woman to curse a child. It is terrible. But I say to you, it is almost equally terrible for a parent not to pray for a child. So if you don't pray for your child, it's almost as good or as bad as you cursing the child. So what am I saying in a nutshell on Parenting 103? It is your duty as a loving parent to pray for your child. Commit that child into the hands of the Creator so that it will be well with the child and so that that child will live long on the earth. I say unto you, don't be late in praying for them. God has instructed you to do that, and God watches over your words to perform it in their lives. Thank you for being a part of today's broadcast. I'll be back with Parenting 104. Keep living real.